There is nothing better than dirt time with another guy who enjoys bushcraft. I recently spent the weekend with Darby of the River Bend Survival School. We learned from each other and practiced bushcraft skills. I learned a simple way to distill water with a stainless steel water bottle and copper tubing. I will add this approach to my arsenal of skills, skills that may be useful in different situations. When hiking, I typically carry water in a stainless steel bottle. And if I'm in an urban area and run out of water, I fill my bottle at a nearby water spigot. If I'm in the backcountry, then I collect water from a nearby stream and use a water filter. Usually, it's a soy mini, which removes 99.99% of all bacteria. If I'm less sure about the safety of the water, I also boil it, essentially eliminating all biological contamination. But the water still may have chemical contamination. For situations where I need to make seawater drinkable, or where heavy metals such as lead, arsenic, and mercury are a problem, distillation is necessary. Distillation is one of the oldest methods for water treatment. Distillation is often used as the preferred method in developing countries that must deal with heavily contaminated, untreated drinking water. Darby's approach to water distillation is simple and practical for bushcraft and survival. The first steam from the still includes volatiles, such as alcohol and oils, that have a lower boiling point than water. So if your objective is to have drinking water that does not have these volatiles, let the first steam escape before collecting the water. But sometimes you may want these volatiles. Say, for example, if you want to extract oil from acorns. Billy Joe Denny has an excellent video on how to do this. There are many variations to using this simple backpack still. Bob 808 Knight, for example, has been testing some of these methods, including using a cork rather than brass fittings or rubber stoppers. If you decide to make a simple still for drinkable water, I recommend testing it in your backyard before using it in a bushcraft or survival situation. I tested mine with salt water that I made, and I learned the following. First, do not completely fill the dirty bottle. Keep it no more than 2/3 full. Boiling bubbles will migrate up the sides of the top of the bottle and into the distillation tube, causing contamination to get into the clean bottle. Second, don't boil it at a strong, heavy heat. Boil it only at barely the boiling point. That way the bubbles stay smaller and there's less contamination from the water migrating into the tube. Next, do not collect the first water from the copper tube. It may have debris and volatiles in it that have a boiling point below that of water. Next, cool the copper tube with a wet rag, and it's wet with dirty water or salt water. But be careful when you do this not to let the water from the rag migrate into the collection container. If necessary, put a clip on the tube to collect the water drips from the rag. Do not boil all the water out of the dirty bottle. Next, test the efficiency of the still in removing salt. And you can easily do this with salt water like I did. And you can do a taste test to see how much of the salt was removed. In commercial distillation processes, water is passed through a still several times to make it totally pure. My experience with this still is that when it passes through it once, there is some salt that goes into the clean bottle. It is more drinkable than the original water, but it does have some salt. Thank you. These are special gourmet cheese sandwiches. Cheddar cheese, topped with Turkey cat flowers, American beauty berry, a little avocado, and chicken. And then I put a little bit of olive oil on the sandwiches. Now these should be absolutely scrumptious. So we'll close each one up and we'll cook them until they're golden brown. This is a very useful grate from Darby. Absolutely indispensable. My meal's all ready. I want to show it to you. Now this is gourmet. Look at it. Gourmet cheese sandwiches with chicken, cheddar cheese, avocado. It's garnished with American beauty berry. I also have that on the side. Turkey cap. Turkey cap is really, really good. Mmm. And then wild grapes. Doesn't that look good? Look at that. Yeah, I know it's a little bit brown on one side. As my dad would say, that will put hair on your chest. So anyway, bon appetit. Mmm. Until next time, peace.